Thanks for staying with us right here on Sunrise as we continue this Hope Day Wednesday. Now, a month of November is also known as National Disability Rights Awareness Month. Now, according to the Statistics South Africa, the population of people living with disabilities in South Africa is over 7.5%, representing over 3 million people. Now, people living with disabilities in South Africa are often faced with different challenges, but this morning we take a look at strides that have been made in the development of for persons with disabilities. To elaborate more on this, we are now joined in studio by Dan Kekane from the Disabled People of South Africa. And you at home can be part of our discussion by giving us your comments on our Facebook and Twitter pages. We're also taking your calls live on 011-447-1742 or 447-2570. Good morning to you, Dr. Kekane. Thanks for joining us this morning.
Good morning to you and good morning to the listeners at home.
All right, so let's talk about the core function and the work that disabled people in South Africa do again. What exactly do you guys do?
To start with, please let me start with a point of rectification. It is not people living with disabilities, because disability is not a living entity, but it is people with disabilities. First, they are human beings, as people, then followed by the condition that they have or the impairment that they have. So it is people with disabilities. Thank you. And then the core business of DPSA is, it's the most responsibility is taking care of the core development of a person with a disability, regardless of the kind of disability and regardless of the situations around them. But we are here to advocate for the rights of people with disabilities, seeing to it that education-wise, they are well represented and they're given the right to get themselves educated and all other spheres of life.
Now, in terms of like those challenges that you're talking about, and rather the work that your organization does, is that annually, you know, the sort of like targets that you set for yourself, that this is what we're tackling this year. What is it that you're looking at this year?
You know, for now, it is very, very difficult for us to set the targets, for us to say, this is what we want to achieve, this is what we want to achieve, because we are not that much empowered, or I could say we are not that much powerful, that is economically, because we have discovered that for us to be able to achieve our goals and most of our goals, it all lies on the financial power and the financial ability to make sure that we put our issues across there. Like right now, we've been fighting and we've been complaining for a number of years that we want disability to be taken into the presidency, but it is still not happening. And in that situation, we are so limping that as a disability movement, we don't have the strength, you know, economically to be able to be in the streets, picketing, making all those noises and making sure that the government hears our plight and really takes it seriously. But with all necessary engagements that we get involved in, we do put that across and we do fight for that to be taken seriously and for that to be taken into consideration.
What would be the significance of it being in the office of the presidency?
So important that if you look at a person with a disability, we look at the development of a person holistically. The person with a disability also needs housing, also needs medical care, also needs legal representation, also needs, you know, all spheres of life.
So it's about access.
It's about access, yes. Now, if all ministers that are here are reporting to the presidency, then there can be a checkpoint whereby all ministers within all departments are able to report. That is why you find the State of the Nation address has nothing speaking about people with disabilities. You find the State of the Province address, nothing about people with disabilities. Why? Because it is only kept at social development, whereby it gives an impression that people with disabilities are social burdens, which is not the case. We also need to participate in the development of the country, you know, actively.
But as an organization, how do you engage with people with disabilities on a daily basis to make sure that their voices are heard, especially, you know, from the ground up? How do you, in a small way, in spite of the challenge that you mentioned, how do you organize people with disabilities?
We do have workshops that we engage in regularly with our people. We do go to our people wherever level they are. We even go to as far as the rural areas of Gauteng and as far as the rural areas of South Africa. DPSA has got a footprint in the whole country. each and every province has a TPSA office in it.
Mm.
So we are able to reach our people from all corners of this country, and we are able to do those workshops in order to, you know, engage our people and to make them aware of their rights and situations around them.
Outside of government, your engagements with the private sector, you know, around issues, let's say access in the workplace, how do you deal with that?
That becomes a very, very problematic issue, because now if you look at the private sector, their core interest is the bottom line.
Mm.
And when you talk of the bottom line, it becomes a bit of a financial burden for them to hire people with disabilities or to employ people with disabilities, because they sometimes look at them as financial burdens.
Mm.
Because in some instances, you'd find that structurally, the company that is located in a certain building, the building is not that user-friendly for people with disabilities. Ablution facilities are not in good standard for a person with a disability to be able to use and access them easily.
Mm.
So for them to employ a person with a disability, it then becomes first a financial burden, in a sense that they need to renovate to make sure that they give room or they make space for that person with a disability that they are going to employ.
Mm.
Now, for private sector, mostly they run away.
In terms of, like, I don't know if you're a membership organization, or how do persons with disability engage with yourselves so that they know their rights and they themselves can be advocates in that private sector, you know, organization that they might find themselves in?
Yes, they do. We are a membership-based organization. We do have people coming in, and people, you know, in their respective places who are doing advocacy work for the organization.
Like, so how do you empower them on a person-to-person?
We do even assist them, whereby when they have workshops, they can even invite us within their workspace, that we can be able to come and assist in order to put the word across on the works of TPSA.
Okay. So in
we also assist even the companies that have people with disabilities in their employ, in making sure that we, you know, try to run workshops in order to assist that people who are working with these other people who have disabilities, we able to normalize the playing field and making sure that we integrate them so that there is no, you know, stigmatization that is attached to either the ones that are disabled or those that are not disabled.
Mm.
So we do assist in those, but we only do that on request of the companies and organizations.
So how do you effectively use the month of November as to create national disability rights awareness across? What sort of programs or things does your organization get involved in?
You see, the month becomes so crucial and important to us, because with this month, that's even when we get people like yourself who are calling us for interviews and to and have us to talk on national media platforms, whereby we are able to talk to our people and able to talk to even those that are not disabled, who can be able to hear us.
Mm.
Otherwise, people who are not having any disabilities, or who don't even have relatives who are having disabilities, they don't even, you know, have time to go to these workshops, to come to our workshops and stuff. It is not a thing that is that much important to them. But when we have a space like this media platform that we have right now, they add so much value that we are then able to reach even those that are not disabled. And we are able to spread our word, you know, in a more vigorous way with such month. And it does really work for us.
So what kind of, I mean, is there specific programs and things that you guys get to do throughout the month of November? What sort of things can people engage with you guys throughout this month about?
You know, to highlight the one, we have an HIV awareness campaign that we're also doing, which we have scheduled it for the 30th of this November in Ekurhuleni in Gauteng, because we are also affected by the scourge of HIV and AIDS.
Mm.
We do have road safety awareness programs that we run as well. So we are doing our best to make sure that we are involved in each and every facet of the society's activities out there, you know, but giving it a disability input and making sure that people with disabilities are the ones who are taking a lead in those activities that are there.